Thank you very much.
Thank you, girl.
Thank you very much. the Beatles' second album in America, and you know, Meet the Beatles had all those great originals. Beatles' second album had started off with, you know, a couple songs that the Beatles didn't write, and we didn't care. They were just too good. So this is our third set, and we're gonna get just a little funky. We're gonna do a funky Rolling Stones song. And believe me, we have our choice. There is a batch of Rolling Stones songs that are so funky that there is moss growing on these songs, even if they don't grow on the Rolling Stones. Oh yeah, they wrote this song. And they lived it. Canestraro.
Yeah, Bobby.
No, it's mine. It's your solo.
Billy's gonna do a drum solo for us now. You ready for that?
Not a song, but a group of songs. A medley, in fact.
A mélange.
By a band that I really used to like when I was like, you know, 14. Maybe even 12.
Sorry. We haven't grown up a bit.
Sandy, too. I think we'll just play it and not stop. Just kind of stop talking about it.
Oh no, I think we should have a roundtable discussion.
Thank you.
So I think we're getting a break on the heat. What do you guys think? I don't know who schedules these things, but they've got it tight with the powers that be. You know, we said 4 hours, July 4th. Sure, that'll be fun. But it ended up being fun. It ended up being really pleasant.
Actually, you know, I played some gigs at the Cherry Creek Arts Festival that were just absolutely
boring. Right, I mean, they don't have a lake there. They don't have a park there.
Hi, bud.
How you doing?
All right,
how are you?
You ready?
Great.
I'm so ready. Yeah, we're going to do this.
I'm in.
Said the time was right for me to follow you.
With a better song than that. Whose songs are those? Who did those songs? Love and Spoonful is exactly right. Give that man 25 points. Okay, and you have another chance to earn another 25 points if you can name this TV game show theme song. You ready? It's a TV show theme song. Well, he didn't get 60 minutes, but thanks for playing our game. It's kind of, yeah, it goes by pretty fast. The train is arriving.
I do, I'm going to get it. Tell him that. What song do you want to play? I know, but tell him that.
Well, we have a very important, famous celebrity in our band. Scott Bennett, our illustrious, fearless leader, is the guy that plays all those little twangy guitar parts when you get on the train at the Denver airport.
Please stand clear of the doors. You're delaying the departure of this train. Thank you, and then I wrote. Thank you, that's the end of that segment. Bob has a request. Well, Summer in the City was a very appropriate song. This one could beat it. Car because you didn't play a little. Is that rock and roll stuff okay for you guys? Can we do another Who song? Okay, this was written by Cindy Lou a long time ago. Cindy Lou Who wrote this song. And Sandy has some special stories to tell you about this bass he's gonna play it on. In case anybody is really kind of getting up the nerve to steal it, it's a replica. So you really wouldn't like it, honest.
It's a replica of the 1966 slab body precision bass that John Entwistle played back in 66 and 67. You can see him playing it at the Monterey Pop Festival of 67.
Start this off with a brief harmonica solo.
This is the only Who song on Atco.
Atco kind of missed out on a lot of stuff, didn't they?
They got Bobby Darin. And the Coasters.
Bobby Darin, if I were a carpenter and you were a lady, I could learn to be a carpenter, okay? Just saying.
Oh,
All right.
Sandy
Buckles on that amazing bass guitar.
Yeah.
Now, we got to check in with you guys. I mean, I know, I see everybody doing the pulse check out there, trying to see if they're, you know, still within legal bounds and everything. We got to find out if we're playing what you guys want to hear. And the only way we're going to find that out is if you tell us. We're a 60s band, Modniks.
Beatles!
Okay, here's the kind of game we like to play. What Beatles song could we play that would make that guy's night?
You Really Got a Hold on Me.
You Really Got a Hold on Me is a great song. It's just a wonderful song. That's kind of why it was the third song of this set. What is it? Oh, you really got, okay. Now we're gonna do the You Really Got a Hold of Me version live at the BBC. So we can see if you guys can tell the difference. Somebody shouted out a Beatles song, we just up and do it.
Yeah. And Your Bird Can Sing.
And Your Bird Can Sing.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Okay, how many people want to hear that? You're not cutting us any slack at all, are you? You guys are great. You've been practicing a long time for this.
All that rehearsal is paying off, man.
See, because everybody, you know, we had some good Beatles songs, but That was a good one, too, right?
Oh, okay, so here's the quiz. If you get it right, you get,
what?
Who was in the Buffalo Springfield? Name the band, at least the three main guys.
You can skip the rhythm
section. Buffalo Springfield.
Okay, you can come up and say it on the mic.
Buffalo Springfield was Stephen Stills, Neil Young, Jim Messina, Richie Furay, and Dewey Martin.
A round of applause.
Yes, so good.
You win a 2-week vacation in Littleton, Colorado. And for the rest of you who are runner up, 3-week vacation in Littleton, Colorado. This is one of the, not the first Buffalo Springfield song you think of, but it's one of the first ones we thought of. Break song.
Would you let me walk down the street, naked if I want to?
One more set to go, and then there's the fireworks. So stick around for one more set. Thanks very much.